Hey, so today we're gonna talk about one. Today we're gonna talk about one of the most common conditions I meet in the clinic. It's amongst climbers, strength trainers, people who don't even do sports. Experience often shoulder impingements. And to start off, we have to kind of understand what is a shoulder impingement. For you to better like grasp what to do about it. So I'm gonna grab the camera for this and see if I can. Yeah, let's move around. Like this, yes. So we have a shallow shoulder here. So impingement is pinching something, but what is it? So in this case, it's the supraspinatus tendon or the bursa connected to it. So where's the supraspinatus? It's right here in the upper scapula, and you can like feel the spine go down here, and it lies in the fossa just above it. And it goes out this way and attaches to the top of your humerus, like the ball joint in here. And what it does, it goes beneath this bony landmark here, it's called acromion. And beneath this, it attaches in here. So it's quite a narrow space, this. So if this space changes in any way, we can get to like rub on the tendon. What the supraspinatus does for living, let's call it that, is it abducts the arm, so it lifts the arm up. And also it stabilizes like your ball joint into the cavity in here during many of the shoulder movements, so it like stabilizes the joint. So like, let's try and understand what goes on in the joint and maybe give you a visual representation of how you better look at this. So I have a program for this, I'll try and switch into it. So let's see. Let's put our dude right here. So what we need to see is right in, let's see, here. So here you have like the scapula, and on top the supraspinatus lays and runs beneath here. So it's inside, right in here. Oh, where did it go? Right in here. On the top here, where you can see it, it attaches to like the left bony landmark. So we need to understand why it starts pinching on this. Most of the time it's because our postural alignment is kind of checked, and we see it so much today with people like we're working outside of self, our shoulders get protracted, and so much in our lifestyle today that causes the condition for this. So we often see protracted shoulders, and along with this, when the shoulders go forward, the space beneath the acromion, the bony landmark on top, and the tendon gets tighter. So when you have to work with your arm above yourself, you'll get a good chance of like rubbing on the tendon on the bursa adjacent to it, and you'll get some kind of tendonitis from this. So what I want to focus on, usually when we have to correct this, is get this understanding, okay, has there been a change of like the postural alignment, and how do we fix this? Because when we go forward, when we get our protracted shoulders, it's not only the shoulders that move forward, but it's also the chest that depresses, and we get like a big rounding up here, the kyphosis. And with this posture, we also often get the neck in front to get like a good stable grounding. So it's also unfortunately a very bad position to be in. Headaches, neck pain, upper thoracic pain. So if you have been in this position for a long time, we're usually pretty tight in the pecs, We build strength between the shoulder blades, at least in flap 3, down here, which helps put your scapula towards your chest. So, we want to do 3 things. We have to think a bit about how we place ourselves in our day-to-day job, like how we're sitting working, our shoulders back, or we're reaching for our workplace. Then we need to get some length on your pecs and some strength in your back. Because this has to be a balance here that keeps you upright. So if you want to work with getting the right posture, try to doing it in slow motion. So you put your postural muscles to work to get into this position. But for sure what you want to do is work with your physio to put out the right program for you to see what has decreased strength in your back and how you get some length on your pecs over here. Because working hard in the back while you're trying to lengthen the pecs is a really good combination. It kind of works together. So that'd be really nice. And then just slowly watch as your strength progresses, how you slowly get stand a bit taller, get your shoulders back and your chest up. It's much about chest up, this work. So how are you gonna know if you're suffering from a soldier
shoulder impingement?
A severe or minor grade up. First of all, most experience the pain in the front of the shoulder. Often describe the pain slow pain. Usually categorize the pain as the between fast or slow pain. Slow or deeper feeling, they like it all. You know that pulsating feeling in the pain in the front of the shoulder. But I have seen many cases of different kinds of pain patterns associated with this. If you want to decrease your pain, often it helps creating a bit more space in between here, and there are a few exercises that you can actually do that would help you do this. So the first one is, I get the camera, or maybe you film me first. And can you get me from the side? So the first exercise you should do is you get a table and you straighten out your back and you apply some force down into the table. So you kind of push down with your back and you should feel your scapula depressing and clinging to your chest. And then you slowly move backwards, keeping the scapula in until you finally get your head between. Keeping the scapula in and walk all the way back, keeping pressing down the table all the time. This creates a bit of space. Another exercise for creating a bit of space is actually hanging. It's not the first thing that comes to mind, but oftentimes, if you go and just hang for a bit, try and create some space and you release, you will often feel a relief from this. Yeah. If you want to strengthen the muscles that might have gotten a bit weaker over the years in the back, you have to think about exercises that push your scapula into your chest. So any work that makes you push back out here. So this motion down here is really important, and also stuff that closes your scapula together on the back. So that'd be any kind of rows. Rows are really, really good. So anything that gets your arms from you and get the scapula together. And you can do also pushing up and try to engage your trap with different angles so you pull down as well. Yeah, I hope this helped out a bit, and try out the exercises. And please comment, subscribe if you want to see more like this. Thank you. Bye-bye.